Hello everyone. Hope you all must be fit and fine now and must have enjoyed the previous lecture in which I was telling you about the movements of the tectonic plate, and side by side I also told you about the formation of the earth due to the movement of these plates, the different relief features of India, and in which I was telling you about the Gondwanaland and the Laurasia, how India was formed, the various relief features were formed in India, and first of all, in that I discussed about the Himalayan mountains. I was telling you about the Himalayan mountains, what Himalayan mountains are there. These are the young cold mountains, and it is about 2400 kilometer long, and its width varies in the east, that is 400 kilometers in Kashmir, to the west, that is 150 kilometers in Arunachal Pradesh. After that, you just learn about the highest peaks of the Himalayas. And after that, I told you the three parallel lines which are running in the Himalayas. First one is the Greater Himalayas. After that, there is the Lesser Himalayas. And the last one is the Shivalik. Okay, and in that I discussed about the type of soils, the mountains which exist, the hill stations, the gorges, the valleys. And in the Shivalik, I also told you these are the lowest hills, which is of 900 and 1100 kilometer, and it is towards the south of these lesser Himalayas. Side by side, I also told you the Himalayan regions from east to west. I told you about the Kumaon Hills, the Nepal Himalayas, and the Assam Himalayas. And children, I forgot to tell you one thing more about the tectonic plate. In this tectonic plate, I would like to show you that these are the different plates. I just told you that there are seven plates. This is something extra which I am telling you. These seven plates are, first you can see the Pacific plate is over here. I would like to show you. The Pacific plate is over here. After that, North America plate is there. Eurasia plate is there. South America plate is there. South Africa plate is there. And Australia plate is there. And one thing I would like to tell you, in Australia plate, on the one side you can see India is there, and on the other side the Australia continent is there. So whenever it is asked to you that on which plate India lies, you are going to answer that it lies on the Australian plate only. So this much is that which I have revised the lecture which I have told you previously. Now today I am going to tell you about the northern plains of India. This is also very interesting, children. You live on the northern plains only. So, don't think that it is only a plain area, a flat area. No, it has also different types of features in it, different types of variations in the features in it. Let me tell you first what are the northern plains and where these plains exist. So, I would like to tell you that it is these northern plains. You can see in a small map over here, this is the plain region over here. Once again, I would like to show you, this is the plain region over here. This is the northern plain. You can see a little bit of this plain area lies in Pakistan. Haryana is there, Punjab is there, Delhi is there, UP is there, Bihar is there, Jharkhand is there, our Assam is there, West Bengal is there. These are the different states which are found in the northern plain region. So children, northern plain, it has been formed by the three major rivers, namely the Indus River, the Ganga River and the Brahmaputra River, and its tributaries are also there. Tributaries, you know what are the tributaries? First of all, let me tell you these rivers along with the tributaries, they form these northern plains. I am going to show you in the other map also where the Ganga, Brahmaputra and its tributaries are. Now this area, it is composed of alluvial soil, and this soil has been deposited by these rivers over the million of years, and the total area. Children, the total area, once again I would like to tell you, this total area of the northern plains is around 2400 kilometer long, okay, and it varies also. That is, somewhere it is of 320 kilometer and somewhere it is of only 240 kilometer in width. 320 kilometer kahi chauda hai aur kahi pe ye sirf 240 kilometer chauda hai. And this is the total area of the northern plain. So let me move further. Okay, you can see here, once again I would like to show you the northern plain. You can see here in our country. I'm going to zoom it now, if it's going to zoom. Okay, so you can see over here In northern plains, you can see Punjab is there, Haryana is there. After that, we can see Uttar Pradesh, Delhi, little bit of Rajasthan is there, Bihar is there, West Bengal is there, Assam is there, Meghalaya is there. This state, the all these states lies in the northern plain of India. Okay, so this much is clear to you. Okay, now we'll move further. Now we are going to say, I'm going to tell you about the different division of the northern plains of India. So in this, I'm going to tell you such a vast plain it is, and it has been divided into three parts. It has divided into three sections. Now the western part I would like to show you. This is the western part. The western part of this northern plain, okay, which is from river Indus and its tributaries. It lies in the plain of this river Indus along with its tributaries. That is the other five rivers. This last part, it also comes in the Pakistan area also. Is it clear? So Indus and its tributaries, the Indus, I can show you here. Once again, I'm going to keep it small. You can see the river Indus over here. This is river Indus. Okay, you can see the river Indus. This is river Indus, river Indus. And these are the tributaries of river Indus. All these are tributaries of river Indus over here. This is river Indus and these are the tributaries. Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias, Satluj. These are the tributaries of these river Indus. Okay, so this section is of plain is dominated by the Doabs. I would like to tell you what are Doabs. Doabs, D-O-A-B-S, D-O-A-B-S. What are Doabs? I'm going to explain you about this also just now. So this is the first part in which Punjab, Haryana and all these regions comes, which is irrigated, the land of these areas are irrigated by these tributaries of river Indus. So I would like to explain you about Doab first. So in this Doab region, this is the picture of Doab. Okay, now you can look over here that in this there are the different tributaries. River Indus is there. After that, you can see the various rivers are there, or tributaries of river Indus. All the five rivers are there. The region which lies in between these rivers, okay, the region which lies in between these rivers are called as Doab. Okay, you can see over here the river Indus is there. Ab yahan pe aap dekhoge Satluj, uske baad aapka Bias hai, ye sab hai inke Ravi, ye Ravi river hai. So inke beech mein ye jo region aata hai isko Doab kehte hain. The region which lies between the two rivers is called as the Doab region. After that, you can see the other rivers also. Satluj is there, iske beech mein jo pani regi, ye bhi Doab aa gaya. उसके बाद आपको यहाँ भी दिखाऊंगी, यहाँ पे द रिवर यमुना इज ओवर हियर एंड द रिवर गंगा इज ऑल्सो फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम हियर. सो द रीजन विच लाइज इन बिटवीन दिस टू रिवर्स इज कॉल्ड एज द ड्वाब रीजन. इन दिस यू कैन सी द मैनी स्टेट्स एंड मैनी डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड सिटीज कम्स ओवर हियर. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द ड्वाब रिवर. यू कैन सी सतलज रिवर ओवर हियर. द अदर रिवर्स आर ऑल्सो, ये जो दो नदी के बीच में जो हिस्सा आता है उसको हम ड्वाब रीजन बोलते हैं. आई होप सो दिस मच इज क्लियर टू यू वॉट इज ड्वाब नाउ. ओके, सो लर्न इट. What is Doab? Okay, after this I would like to explain you further. Now you can see, I'm going to show you here. Now these are the three divisions over here. First one is the upper Ganga, the Punjab Haryana plain. Ye three parts mein divided hai. First is the Punjab Haryana plain. Okay, uske baad this area three parts mein divided hai. ओके, फ्रॉम रिवर इंडस एंड रिवर इंडस की ट्रिब्यूटरीज है वो आपका एक हिस्सा हो गया. द वन सेक्शन इज जो पंजाब हरियाणा में आता है, दिस इज पंजाब हरियाणा प्लेन. आफ्टर दैट द अदर एरिया गंगा प्लेन कम्स हियर. इट एक्सटेंड्स फ्रॉम रिवर घाघर टू रिवर तिस्ता रिवर. फ्रॉम हियर रिवर घाघर टू रिवर तिस्ता, तिस्ता इज इन आसाम. ये जो रीजन होता है इसको हम गंगा प्लेन्स बोलते हैं. इन विच मैनी पार्ट ऑफ मैनी स्टेट्स कम्स ओवर हियर ऑफ नॉर्थ इंडिया. Like Haryana, little bit of Haryana is there, Delhi is there, UP is there, Bihar is there, एंड पार्टली थोड़ा बहुत झारखंड आ जाता है एंड वेस्ट बंगाल टू इट्स ईस्ट। ये पूरा जो एरिया होता है आपका रिवर घग्गर से लेकर रिवर सिस्टा तक, इसको हम जो है गंगा प्लेन बोलते हैं। ये गंगा प्लेन भी थ्री पार्ट में, गंगा प्लेन हैज ऑल्सो बीन डिवाइडेड टू थ्री पार्ट, द अपर गंगा प्लेन, द मिडिल गंगा प्लेन एंड द लोअर गंगा प्लेन। ओके, दिस हैज ऑल्सो बीन डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री पार्ट, द गंगा प्लेन हैज बीन डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री पार्ट। सो फर्स्ट सेक्शन वॉज द पंजाब हरियाणा प्लेन, सेकेंड सेक्शन वॉज द गंगा प्लेन। गंगा प्लेन के भी थ्री पार्ट्स हैं, अपर गंगा प्लेन, मिडिल गंगा प्लेन एंड द लोअर गंगा प्लेन। एंड इन दिस साइड बाई साइड इट इज जनरली डिस्क्राइब्ड एज फ्लैट लैंड। उसके बाद आपका थर्ड जो एरिया आता है इट इज द ब्रह्मपुत्र प्लेन। सो दीज आर द थ्री सेक्शन, फर्स्ट इज पंजाब हरियाणा प्लेन, आफ्टर दैट इज गंगा प्लेन एंड द थर्ड इज द ब्रह्मपुत्र प्लेन। ओके, सो आफ्टर दिस I can show you in this also map also. You can see over here also. First you can see the Punjab plain is there. Punjab plain is there. Ganga plain is there. And after this Brahmaputra plain is there. So Indus and its tributaries lies in the Punjab plain. In Ganga plain, the river Ganga and Yamuna along with its tributaries, they are in the Ganga plain. Okay. And Ganga plain is also divided into three parts. The first part is the upper Ganga, the middle Ganga and the lower Ganga. And after that we have the Brahmaputra plains, in which Assam and other regions of the northeastern states comes over here. Okay. After this, I would like to tell you this Punjab plain. In this Punjab plain, it is formed by Indus and its tributaries. Tributaries are Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias and Satluj. And major portion of this plain is in Pakistan. Dwarfs abound in this plain. Ganga plain, it extends between Ghaggar and Tista river. And the northwestern states, isme ye sare states aapke aate hain. And Brahmaputra plains, this plain forms the eastern part of the northern plains and it lies in Assam. And I told you about the Dwarf also. Okay, so other about the Bhabha, Tarai, Bhangar and Khadar, I'm going to discuss in the other lecture. So in this lecture, I told you about the, once again I would like to revise it, that in northern plains, what are the northern plains, how are these northern plains formed, and side by side, I told you how much long it is, what is the width of it, and what kind of soil is found over here, alluvial soil is found over here, because rivers which are up from the mountains, take alluvial soil, that is why here fertile soil is found. ठीक है, वाटर एडुकेट होता है, फेवरेबल क्लाइमेट होता है, एंड एग्रीकल्चरली इट इज ऑल्सो वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट बिकॉज यहाँ पे प्रोडक्शन, एग्रीकल्चर प्रोडक्शन सबसे ज़्यादा होता है। इज इट क्लियर? एंड रिवर्स जो ऊपर से आती हैं फ्रॉम माउंटेन्स, दे आर इन्वॉल्व इन द डिपोजिशनल वर्क, ऊपर से सब कुछ लेके आती है, डिपोजिट करती हैं, लोअर कोर्स में जब वो नीचे आती हैं, इट जेंटली स्लोप्स एंड वेलोसिटी जो रिवर की होती है, जो स्पीड होती है, इट गेट्स डिक्रीजेस, और जब ये डिक्रीज होती है इससे क्या होता है, यहाँ पे रिवराइन आइलैंड फॉर्म होते हैं। आई टेल यू इन अबाउट द रिवराइन आइलैंड इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर।